Hi, I'm Kirsten, and this is Done DIY. Today we're going to build a fence with horizontal boards. Once your fence posts are installed securely, you can get to work. The first step is to plan your design. Our design alternates 1x6 and 1x2 cedar fence boards with a gap, but the options are endless. At this stage, it's important to decide whether you want the fence boards to run across the face of the posts or to be flush with them. We chose the former method and snapped a chalk line vertically in the center of the post as a reference point. Next, mark a spot for the top rail. We positioned ours to hide behind the top fence board. Attach yours in a way that works best for your design. Then cut your rails to length. They should be just a bit shorter than the distance between your two posts. Cut even shorter if you plan to use fence clips. Once they're cut, attach the ends of each rail to the post with nails, screws, or fence clips. From there, attach your boards horizontally. Our span is just shy of 8 feet, so we purchased 8-foot boards. Measure the posts from center to center, cut boards to that length, then fasten your top board to the posts. Use a level to make sure it's horizontal. To create the look we did, use a 1x2 as a spacer board to create a 3/4-inch gap between boards. Attach your fence board, then remove the spacer and repeat. Work your way down until you're just a few inches off the ground. Attach the bottom rail before anchoring your final board in place. Because 8 feet is a long span for fence boards, we added a vertical 2x2 at the center of the run. Consider doing this for your fence too. Once you've finished your first section, move on to the next and repeat the steps. If you want, you can cover the joint where boards from neighboring sections meet with a 1x4. When the fence is done, it's time to add a final finishing touch, post caps. Post caps come in tons of styles, so find something that suits you. Then sit back, relax, and enjoy your new outdoor living space.